should the American public be ready for actual shortages of meat and related animal products here in the supermarkets at the stores?
You know, I don't think there's going to be a shortage nationally. In other words, I think there's going to be enough supply to feed the American public. I mean, about 30% of everything that's produced in this country gets exported. So we're obviously in a position where we can fulfill the needs of people in this country. But there may be local or regional disruptions because a plant closes, because of the nature of the supply chain today. There may be a shortage here or there. But overall, I think we're going to I don't think anybody needs to be worried about whether or not there's going to be enough food. The big challenge, though, is to get food to the people that need it. When you've got 30 million unemployed folks, suddenly unemployed folks, there's a tremendous demand on food banks and pantries. And again, most of what they would get from a donated standpoint historically has come from retail. Well, retail doesn't have food to donate because we're buying it off the shelves. So the question is, how do we create a supply chain that will allow us to gradually redirect the food that would otherwise go to food service to food banks to take some of the pressure off of them? And as food service comes back online, how do we make sure that we keep that supply chain stable and healthy?
If you were still Secretary of Agriculture, any immediate steps that haven't been taken that you would take to try to further stabilize our food supply chain?
Well, first of all, I think Secretary Perdue's got a really, really tough job. And I know he and his team are working through it. But I think one thing that could be done, that I think should be done, is to consider the ability of raising the SNAP, the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, resource and benefit. The reality is you can send stimulus checks in the mail, and some folks get them and some folks don't get them. And it takes a while for them to get them. And some people use them to pay down their Visa bill. And does that necessarily stimulate the economy? Uncertain. But what we do know from data and what we do know from history is that SNAP benefit does get spent. It gets spent within 30 days. 95% of it gets spent. So to the extent that you provide those unemployed workers and their families the capacity to buy just a little bit more at the grocery store, the chances are that they will, in fact, do that.